Welcome to yet another episode of Kathumi. I have blessed her channel with my presence. My name is Dee, and she'll reintroduce me here.
My name is Victoria Kathumi, and yeah. Oh, so this is us reviewing.
This is it. So this is it. Is something that has brought us together. Because every time we'd watch, or it will be put up on YouTube, I'd put up a status, and then minutes later she'd put up a status, and we'd discuss about it, and we decided, why not do a review? So here's the review. And
yeah, I hope you guys watched it, because it's
come to an end. Sadly, although I was thinking today that I am happy and sad that it's ended, because okay, happy because of those happy feelings you used to tell me about after
and the fact walikuwa natuonyesha marriage is so awesome. You're thinking, Jesus,
I can't wait to get married
in the real world or something.
But sad or happy, because they did a very short web series, but it was totally worth it, because they showed us a whole year of their marriage, and then they didn't overbore us. They just knew.
For me, I think it's a sad feeling. I didn't want to talk to you, then they were like, you know, I don't want them to ever finish that series.
You think you could watch it forever?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
I was waiting for their kids. I could use that.
Maybe Tommy Day and Dede. And what makes it authentic and different is that T and Dede are from very different backgrounds. T is Kenyan and Nigerian. That's
Dede.
His name.
Yeah. Oh, he's Kenyan and Nigerian.
Yeah, T is Ameru, his name is Mwenda, and Dede is Nigerian.
Because it's through Dede. And then they get married,
Very then... beautiful wedding. Okay, we see
what
the pictures.
It?
No, we see the pictures.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. But you have forgotten to say, that what drew us was how T proposes to Dede. Did you forget the pickup lines that Sijui, Dede, you're my homie, my best friend, Sijui, we can try this, and she's there laughing and thinking he's joking, and it was so cute and cheesy, and we wanted to die. Yeah, and then now
it's so simple, but we're like,
the simple things blow you away. So the girlfriends being who they are come and clash. And we feel then
Dede is mad. Dede is like, I was planning something, because girl, she was planning to like do this hot thing for
T,
and then anasikia tu knock, like, and how would you feel?
Yeah,
I would also be devastated anyway.
Then I remember one of the friends telling Dede, okay, when they were knocking, and then they've come, so she's like, Dede, ati Tommy Dem Wanda, we have come. And they were like, we were married, all of us. The moment you married T, it became like you married all of us. Which is something we relate to, because if you have your squad, your group of girls, and one of you guys is dating, it's usually your relationship.
It's ours. I am definitely texting her what this
tell
guy
me.
Has said.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I think
that was it
one,
for episode one.
Yeah, and then season one was just
all happy.
So much laughter.
Yeah, and at the end of it all, your parents know something, and you should always consult them, because this is time Dede alienda kwa babake and T alienda kwa mamake. You remember?
Yeah.
So like alikuwa, their mom was like, hey, take care of your wife, you should be the provider, you should take care of her. Si kama mother-in-laws wengine.
Yeah, wako. Ati hapiki.
Ati hapiki.
Ati haja kwa kifua.
It was a learning lesson for everyone. Like, parents should be supportive.
But anyway, let us not bore you with those details and rush on to episode 10.
Two.
No,
oh.
Episode 10.
Oh, yeah, episode 10.
Okay. What happened in episode 10-ish? Which also, although we can say, Pia, they were just 6 months into the marriage.
Yeah.
So it was kind of hard to make a decision whether you'd leave your marriage when it's such a baby, and then go and work Maju. So anyway, that came to the end of season one, which had very amazing soundtrack. I don't know if you saw that it had really amazing soundtrack. Like episode 10 had a very, very nice song that I love. It was called Kijana, it's by Waithera. I love Kenyan music.
Alafu pia Waithera ni banga vizuri.
Yeah.
But we are not talking about Waithera.
So you go and check her out. She's a really amazing Kenyan artist.
No, season 2!
I'm sure this was your season.
Definitely, it was my season because they met up.
Yeah, she used to text me the details. Like, did you see the part where he said this to her? And I'm like, girl, chill. I just watched the overview. I saw everything that happened, but not the details.
Music is everything because everything they say, it's either funny. Ama, it's extra sweet. You're thinking my husband should take notes.
Yeah, like
my future husband should be taking notes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So season 2 episode 1, Jay decides to drop the job. Logging, because she thinks Steve will
at
be
a drum.
Yeah, will be like, why didn't you take the job? But he's a T is like okay, fine.
Imagine.
After I drop a job
for you, you're like, it's fine.
Yeah.
I really needed you anyway.
Yeah, like on to the next job in Nigeria, not abroad.
So I put after another job, and then
she found another job with her uncle, who I thought was hitting on her. I don't know. It was very weird.
That was nice for an uncle.
It was like, maybe atakuwa, maybe sasana mkatia, and then she'll have to leave the job. But it didn't happen that way.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so what do you think about season 2? It was like, season 2 was a lot like honeymoon ends and what
it's
what's
not
next.
The real shit.
Yeah.
Real shit. You're planning, you think, oh.
Yeah, where I said, God give me a man like T. I remember when they came back home and then the test was negative, and Dede told T about the whole family thing, lineage, and he was like, let us trust in God together in faith. Yeah, it was a big deal. I think a man who wants you to pray with them, like leads you in prayer, is a big deal.
Yeah, and it's a very big deal.
They're hard to find. So if you're watching and you're a man, you can take a leap. Anyway, so it was so many onions being cut. We were always crying through the episodes.
Did you like literally cry?
No, okay, not cry, just sad. Okay, not cry. But I was really sympathizing with them. I was feeling with them. This was like our journey. I usually felt like I could go and advise them, like tell them, no, don't do this. But then anyway, it's a web series, so.
Me, like, what more of when am I going to get this kind of a man? Every time.
Yeah.
Siko na think past that. Kama yo yaku advice, Niko, like, will I really get a tea in my life?
Like, I need a tea.
Someone who wants to pray with me, someone who supports me, someone who. Because at this part, when she wants to go get some shopping, alafu wana mwamsha. I think in some last episode, anamsha alafu wako like, no, I'm not taking you. I go like, I don't need that. I meant your card.
Your card. Oh, yes. Yes. And then it was called the reawakening.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, when they found the meaning in their marriage. Mm-hmm. But we're going to leave out the other episode so that you go and watch if you haven't watched. It's actually a very amazing web series.
Yeah.
And we could speak loads about it.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But then, Atwizi Maliza, without touching on the reawakening, well, she finally gets pregnant.
Yes.
I feel like when you miss much, she finally gets pregnant. Come up when you expect, obviously, a soap.
Yeah.
Isn't this person will end up together?
Yeah.
But then, yeah, she finally gets pregnant.
It actually ends like a soap opera. Church, okay, nothing churchy, but like happily ever after. But it's a really nice thing. It makes you feel really nice. If you're looking for the positive vibes, no bad vibes, just wake up on a Tuesday and watch it.
Yeah.
And it will just make you feel. Yes!
Done for today. So, I guess that's it.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is it.
I won't let you go.